Okay, let me assume a situation. I take, I assume a classroom in which there are a lot of students. Now, if one student pushes another student, is it an external force or internal force for the classroom? It is an internal force for the classroom. If you move in a bus and there are two friends who are pushing each other inside the bus, then is that force external or internal?
It is an internal force for the
It is the internal force for the bus. Okay, agreed. So two students fighting in a class is internal force. Two students playing inside a bus is internal force. Then, can you define an internal force so that we can define external force again? Yeah, let me give another example. So my favorite example, I am pushing the board. The force applied by me on the board, is it external or internal?
External force.
Yeah, all of you. So if I'm pushing the board with my hand, the force that I'm applying on the board, is it external or internal? Yeah, Krishnam told me it is external. Akshat, what about you? So Priya says external.
Sir,
Akshat, what
I
about you?
can't understand. Yes, sir, I can't understand external internal force.
Okay, you can't understand external and internal force, no problem. So see, now when do we say, see, a force is external or internal? If I know what am I, see, let's say if I say I am inside house, so I'm an internal object for the house. If I say I am outside the house, I am an external object for the house. So what does it mean? It means that unless and until I say that there is a house, I cannot say whether I'm inside the house or outside the house. So I need some reference. Similarly, for us to define a force is external or internal, what do we need? We need to define the system. So sabse pehle hame kya karna hai? We have to define the system. We have to define the system. And once we define the system, then anything which is inside the system is internal, and anything which is outside the system is external. Let me give you an example. I take the example of I am pushing the board, right? Now, most of you said that it is an example of external force. Fine, you are correct. And you would have been correct even if you said it is internal force. Why? Now, if I take the board as well as my hand as system, then it is an internal force because my hand and board are system and my hand is a part of the system. But if I take only board as system, then what is my hand? My hand is not a part of the board, not a part of the system. So it is coming from outside. So my hand is what? External force. I hope it is clear. So what decides whether a force is external or internal? The system decides whether a force is external or internal. So how do I define external force? A force applied, on a system or force applied by a system is external force. I hope you're getting it. If I say board is system, I'm applying force on the board with my hand. So the force that I'm applying on the board, is it external or internal?
External.
Yeah. Why is it external? Because system, who is system? Board is system, right? Now, because I am pushing the board is also pushing me. So the force with which board is pushing me, is that external or internal? Now, who is system here in this case? System is board. So is it external or
Internal.
internal? I hope you understood. Who is system? System is board. I am pushing the board. That is definitely external. Now, board is pushing me is also external because board is applying force on an external body. So, in this way, how do we define an external body or external force? A force applied on the system or by the system is called external force. So, how do I define external force? External force is what? A force applied on the system or by the system. I hope it is clear. So a force applied on the system or by the system is called is what? External force. So If external force is a force applied on the system or by the system, then what is internal force?
So the force applied by a part of the system on the other part of the system.
Yes. So what is internal force? Internal force would be a force applied by one part of the system on another part. So internal force. What is internal force? Force applied by one part of the system on another part. So for any force, for us to know whether it is an external or internal, I should know what is system. Unless and until we know what is system, we can't be sure whether a force is external force or internal force.